Kosha, Baka Payela, Kita Rodo Shelema, Le Pakoske Jab, Le Krishte Kiba Avrosta, Liba Kamande, Le Gemo Sakata.
Hello, lovely viewers. This is Abena, and I'm going to be your host for today's talk show. And with me here, I have a very wonderful and powerful man of God, Brother Abuti.
Hello, guys.
Also with me here, I have a very wonderful and beautiful sister, Sister Mati.
Hello.
And today, we're going to be talking about a very interesting and exciting topic. So sit back,
relax, and enjoy the show.
Would like to thank our man of God for the wonderful opportunity to be your host for today's talk show. Thank you so much, sir. I'd also like to thank the members and organizers of the Beihua Fellowship. Thank you so much. Lastly, I'd like to thank the members for your presence here today. Thank you so much. I love you so much. On set with me, I have Brother Abuti.
Hello, everyone.
Welcome. And Sister Mati.
Hello, viewers.
And today, as we said in our promo video, we are going to discuss an exciting topic titled
Speaking in tongues.
Okay, so guys, stay tuned and enjoy the show. Brother Abuti, welcome again. When we say speaking in tongues, what is the concept? What does it mean?
All right, thank you. First of all, I would like to thank the men of God, the fellowship, all the members and all the viewers at home for taking this time be taught by God through His Word. Thank you all. I'm addressing your question. Speaking in tongues, it is a supernatural language that God created for the new church, for the body of Christ. This language He gave as a promise in the Old Testament, reading from Isaiah 28, verse 11, where He said that He will speak to His people with stammering lips and in another tongue. And in the New Testament, this is where you find the fulfillment of His promise in Acts 2, reading from verse 1 to 4, where the apostles received the Holy Ghost and spoke with other tongues, those new tongues, as the Spirit of God gave them utterance.
Okay, so that is to say the prophecy was made in the Old Testament and came to fulfillment in the New Testament.
Yes.
Wow. What doesn't mean that the people in the Old Testament, they never spoke in tongues?
No, the people in the Old Testament, they never spoke in tongues. And mind-blowingly too, even Jesus, our Lord, He never spoke in tongues.
I didn't know that, so thank you.
Let me clarify that for you. It was because this gift was for the new church, and the new church started with the apostles. That is where the gift of speaking in tongues began from.
Thank you so much for your answer, Brother Abuti. Sister Mati,
yes.
What are the types of tongues?
Before I answer your question, I would just like to thank our man of God for giving me the opportunity to be here on today's talk show. I would also like to thank our viewers for finding the time to watch our talk show today. Back to your question, yes, there are three types of tongues, that is the tongues of men, the tongues of God, and the tongues of the devil. And this can be found in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 1.
Okay, I would also like to know this. Must every Christian speak in tongues? Now that we are Christians, is it a must for us to speak in tongues?
Yes, and this can be drawn from the book of Jude chapter 20, which says, "But beloved, build yourselves up on your most holy faith, pray in the Holy Spirit." And the Holy Spirit in this case refers to speaking in tongues. So as we think about the question of whether as Christians we should speak in tongues or not, I would like us to draw our minds to the three questions that I have available for you here. The first one being, is it possible you are losing some of your battles because you are not building yourselves up spiritually? And the second one being, is it possible you are losing some battles because you are not allowing your spirit to pray, because you are constantly praying with your mind, meaning you never actually go beyond what your mind is thinking or what your mind is feeling? And then the third one being, is it possible you are losing some battles because you're not putting on your whole armor? And as we answer this one, I would like us to read from the book of Ephesians chapter 6, verse 17 and 18. Firstly, verse 17 says, take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. And I would like us to pay particular attention to verse 18, which says, praying always with all prayers and supplication in the Spirit. So part of our armor is actually praying in the Spirit, which is speaking in tongues. And in conclusion to this, I would like to say that to every Christian who is filled with the Holy Spirit, they all have the ability to speak in tongues. It's just that they probably haven't stepped out of it yet.
Sort of activated it.
Yes, definitely. And since everything comes by faith, I would like us to take a small little example in our day-to-day lives, like swimming for the first time. You have to, whenever you want to swim for the first time, you have to unconsciously free your mind and allow yourself to float on water. So in the same way, I would like to encourage our Christian brothers and sisters out there to take a leap of faith and desire the gift.
Wow. Thank you so much for that lovely and detailed answer, Sister Mati. Brother Abuti, what are some of the reasons why we as Christians should speak in tongues or must speak in tongues?
Thank you for the question. Addressing your question, one of the main reasons why as Christians we must speak in tongues is for I create communication with God. Our human minds and our worldly languages, they are not pure enough to talk to God, to communicate with God. This is why God created this gift of speaking in tongues. For I create communication with Him. And also, another reason is that it is a coded language. The coding part about the language is that we cannot understand it, and hence when we speak it from our spirit, and in doing so even the devil himself cannot understand it. Let me give a scripture concerning that. 1 Corinthians 14:2, and it reads, for he that speaketh in an unknown tongue speaketh not unto men but unto God, for no man understandeth him. So if we were to understand this gift of speaking in tongues, then the devil also will understand it, and hence our prayers will be unfruitful. But thank God for the coding, so that we ourselves, we don't understand it, and even the devil does not understand it. I'm getting back to the third important reason, is that we speak mysteries. Those who speak in tongues, they speak hidden things. Let me give an example. For example, sometimes when you pray in tongues, when you speak in tongues, the Holy Spirit will make intercession for you through you. That is to say, should there be anything concerning you when you speak it out, when you pray in tongues, the Holy Spirit will take care of those things for you. If there is a plot against you, or even your future, sometimes also things that doesn't concern us, things that may concern other people also. That would be the reasons for speaking in tongues.
Okay. So that is to say, if you are speaking in tongues, you don't understand what you're saying.
When you are speaking in tongues, you don't understand what you're saying.
But that's where I find it a little dicey, because I've heard people speak in tongues and they've interpreted it. So why is that happening?
Okay. Allow me to elaborate that. There's what we call prophesying in tongues. Prophesying in tongues is whereby when you speak in tongues, you are giving out a prophecy, and this is usually in a church or in a gathering. And in such situations, God will give interpretation. Sometimes the interpretation is given to the one who speaks in tongues, or somebody else in the congregation to address speaking in tongues. So it is only in that situation whereby there's a prophecy in tongues that there will be an interpretation in tongues. That is where we get the understanding. Apart from that, those who speak in tongues, they don't understand it.
Okay. Thank you so much for that clarification. Sister Mati.
Yeah.
What are the importance of speaking in tongues, if there's any?
Okay. Thank you so much for your question. Under the importance of speaking in tongues, the first one would be that it helps your prayer life. And that is to say, it allows you to increase the amount of time you spend in prayer with the Lord. And I can take a little example of myself. Before I started speaking in tongues, I would spend a minimum amount of prayer because most of the time we tend to run out of words, if I can put it that way. So when I speak in tongues, I'm able to spend a large amount of prayer and in the presence of God. And even after and within the process of actually speaking, I wouldn't grow weary. I wouldn't get tired of it. And I would really be enjoying the feeling of being in the presence of God. The second point would be that it allows the Holy Spirit to intercede for us. This is mentioned in Romans chapter 8, verse 26, which reads, "Likewise, the Spirit also helps in our weaknesses, for we do not know what we should pray for as we ought to. But the Spirit himself makes intercessions for us with groanings which cannot be uttered." And since our spirits make intercessions for us, this statement from the verse will enable me to bring out my third point, which is it enables us to accurately communicate with God. Because it will enable us to know what is needed to be prayed for at a particular time or probably even in a particular period. And this can be seen from the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 14, verse 2, which says, "He who speaks in an unknown tongue does not speak to men, but to God." And it also enables us to know that it's one of the signs of, as a believer, that you have an infilling of the Holy Spirit. And lastly, it enables us to have a certain amount of boldness to face the world and definitely the future ahead of us. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Sister Mati, for your answer. Brother Abuti, since speaking in tongues is a language, is there a way we can grow in it?
Oh, thank you for the question. Like any other language in the world, you know, if you want to grow in a particular language, you have to speak it more, and also you speak it with the natives. Same thing goes for speaking in tongues. What you can do is that you can speak the language the more. Keep speaking it, and in doing so, you will grow in it. And also, those who speak more in tongues, you can get around them, hold hands together, and you speak the language together. What you can do also is that whenever you are praying in tongues, you should maintain consistency. So always be persistent in your prayer, and that in doing so, you should pray it out loud. You know, that is one way of opening up your spirit. All these things will help you in growing in tongues.
Wow.
Thank you.
Since Jesus speaking in tongues is a language, can it be taught? And if it can be taught, because I've heard, and if somebody is out there who is speaking in tongues and has been taught, is the person doing it wrongly?
Addressing your question, we can never be taught to speak in tongues. First of all, it's because it is a coded language and we don't understand it. Those who speak in tongues, they don't understand it as it is being given in 1 Corinthians 14. So if somebody doesn't understand what they're teaching, how are they going to communicate it to? That is one of the first questions you ask yourself. And also, it is this Holy Spirit giving you utterance. It is not you speaking from your mind, it is you speaking from your spirit, as the Spirit of God gives you utterance. So you can be taught to speak in tongues. And should there be anyone out there who was taught to speak in tongues, I would boldly say that you were taught wrong. What you are doing is wrong, because speaking in tongues, it is a spiritual language. It is not taught by humans, and there is no way somebody can tell you how to speak it, because what you will say is that you also ask for like meaning or want to know the interpretation, but you don't have the interpretation, you don't have the meaning, you don't have the understanding to it. So it is as clear as that. You can be taught to speak in tongues.
Okay, Sister Mati, if there's anyone out there who hasn't yet received the gift of speaking in tongues, or who has also received the gift but then is not growing in it, what advice would you have to give if there's anyone like that?
For my Christian brothers and sisters out there who haven't yet received the gift, I would simply advise them to take a leap of faith and desire the gift, because it's such an amazing thing and it helps you really grow in faith as a Christian.
Thank you so much for that. Brother Abuti, anything you'd like to add up?
Adding on to what she said, one thing that is certain about this gift is that it is part of the package of salvation. So when you are born again, you automatically have the gift in you. So what you can do is that you can pray about it in order to activate it in your spirit. And also, you can consult your man of God in your fellowship, in your church, and inform him that you want to know more about speaking in tongues, so that he can give you the reference on how to do it. He will guide you through. He will either pray for you or lay your hands on you. And one more important thing is that, you see, this journey of Christianity is a journey of faith. And it is one thing that you should know, that you should believe. The Bible says that in the Gospel of St. Mark 16:17 says that these are the signs that will follow them that believe. So you need to believe. One of the signs is speaking in tongues. So you need to believe. Believe in the gift that you have it in your spirit and desire for it. Once you desire it, God will, by the grace of God, you will receive it.
Thank you so much. Thank you once again, guys, for your presence here, for honoring our invitation, you know, to be on set today. In conclusion, I would like to say this topic on speaking in tongues has been very, very enlightening for me in person, because with now I've gotten to know that, and you all out there, viewers, you've also gotten to know that speaking in tongues is a spiritual language. You know, it's a language that no man can teach you, you know, because so if your pastor or someone is teaching you how to speak in tongues, you are doing it all wrong, because the origin is the Holy Spirit. He gives you utterance. No man can. And also, we've learned that as Christians, it is a must for us to speak in tongues. If you are not speaking in tongues, how are you going to, you know, journey on your Christian life? You know, we've also learned the reasons why we are supposed to speak in tongues. And the reasons have been that it is a coded language, and also our humanly words, languages, are not pure enough, you know, to communicate with God. So speaking in tongues is something God created, you know, to kind of make us speak with Him. And also we've learned the importance. And for me personally, the importance has been very wonderful for my personal life, because, you know, the Bible said, "He that speaketh in an unknown tongue emboldens himself." And I've been so bold by speaking in tongues. Oh, I couldn't be sitting here talking to you all. No, I couldn't have. And I've been edified. My spirit has been so alert from now. You know, so much power has been made available for me. And we've also gotten to know that speaking in tongues is one of the signs of the infilling of the Holy Spirit. And that's so amazing, you know. And for everyone out there who hasn't received the gift of speaking in tongues, I would entreat you all, you know, to desire it, because it's so wonderful when we pray in tongues. You know, the Holy Spirit makes intercessions through us. That's the part that intrigues me, because you might be, the Holy Spirit might be praying for you for something you might need in 5 years, but you wouldn't know it because your human mind, you know, is limited. But then the Spirit of God makes intercessions through you. So you realize in 5 years you didn't ask for this, but you have it. The Holy Spirit is the one that prayed for it. So I'd entreat everyone, you know, to desire the gift of speaking in tongues. And for those who are not growing, as we said, the ways you can grow: speak with other people, speak it frequently, every time, you know, and we all grow in speaking in tongues. It's a wonderful gift. Thank you so much, guys, for staying tuned to watch us. Thank you so much again, Brother Abuti. Thank you so much, Sister Mati. Okay, thank you, viewers. We love you so much. Bye.
Bye.
I dreamed I went to heaven. You were there with me. We walked upon the streets of gold beside the crystal sea. We heard these angels singing, and someone called your name. You turned and saw this young man, and he was smiling. as you came. And he said, friend, you may not know me now. Then he said, but wait, you used to teach my Sunday school when I was only 8. And every week you would say a prayer before the class would start. One day when you said that prayer, I asked Jesus in my heart.